Hello, welcome back to our Mnegit course. For today, I will try to create a new management agent for AD. So we open Microsoft Identity Manager, and I'm gonna just do some import from my AD into MIM. So currently you can see there's nothing there, no management agents, just a bare metal installation. So we go to management agents and create. And I'm gonna do AD drop down. You can see there's a gull, there's lightweight, there's different attribute for different, you know, purposes: IBM, LDAP, Novell, Oracle, and Oracle Database and SQL. So I'm just gonna do AD one first, and I will call it AD. And let's just be more specific. IT Lundy underscore AD. So this is the coming from IT Lundy. Forest name, it's called IT Lundy. Username, I'm going to use the same account, admin, go permission to that forest, specify the password, and domain is IT Lundy as well. You can have options here, options you can use different you know, traffic or certificate if it's trust relationship. So next to this, assuming putting the right information, and I will try to reach out to my domain, and you can see there IT Lundy spelled wrong. So let's go on and spell right the domain IT Lundy, and next, and that should basically connect. Here we go. Well, previously I typed it wrong. So you select the right domain, assuming you go one single domain, single forest, but if you go multiple, they all display here. Select the domain. Domain controller, if you would like to do the configuration against domain controller, preferred one, then you got options. You can say tick the tick box, and you can specify the domain controller. In our scenario, we got only one server, so it doesn't matter what options we select, what configuration, credentials, if we need to check it. You see the containers here, different containers. In your scenario, it might be different. So, I mean, I don't need to sync everything, so I'm going to take out the tick box. I'll do just the users objects, and this is all what I need for our exercise. Maybe later on we will do the computer objects if we do some security around certificate management, but we can revisit all of these, you know, and same with security. Next, just to keep it very neat, you can say advanced, and you can say include, exclude, and this is what we're going to do. Okay, here, and if you want to enable password sync, we are not doing password sync at the moment, we will do it later on. Okay, so next is where you specify the provisioning history. I'm going to leave it as it is default, but if you would like to create a new one, here we go. It's an O, DNO, and OU. You can say new, and you can select exactly, for example, account or OU level, and you can say show all attributes. These are attributes are available for you, just in case if you would like to configure different hierarchy. So I'm just going to go untick that tick box again, and go next. Leave it as it is, groups, and I might use users objects, object type, user object, contact maybe later on, and groups as well. I need to use these ones. You can say show all if you need to, but I'm just going to keep it that at the moment. Next is the attribute. Again, show all what attribute you want to use. So I will use given name, maybe employee ID, display name, department, company. The reason why I'm selecting these, at later on I might utilize them for, you know, like Oracle or other, you know, exercises. UPN, maybe street. What else did I miss? Maybe mobile number. And some accounts, which is important. Post address, physical address, OU, I don't need OU at the moment. Email, maybe, yes. What else do we call there? Initial, I've selected, I think this is enough for us to start with. Yep, let's go next. Title, maybe, yeah. Next, and contact domain, if you want to do filters, I'm just going to do the users. And that will be, we'll keep it at the moment, we'll change them later on. Okay, because we can do new and you can select what filters, but at the moment I'm going to keep it as it is, just like high level what is it. Next, same thing apply to the joiners. If I do joiners, and again you can click here new joiners and you can select how you want to join the users, like employee ID against maybe I don't know Excel decimal numbers or user account, or there's an employee ID here, you know. So we'll have a look, see employee ID against employee ID. We'll talk about this later on. Yeah, just cancel this and next, and same thing apply to the contract attribute. Next, make them disconnected. So I'm going to leave them as it is to start with, and later on we'll show different options with different you know result. Now here there's no rule extension name, there's nothing coming from Oracle or no other systems, so I'm just an AD and I'm going to say finish it. So that was basically a high level. So I've got my IT Lindy. A basic practice is to create a user profile for it to do the activity. So if I do right click here and say create profile, so you can do configure profile, configuration here, new profile, and here I'm going to call it just a purely AD underscore maybe I don't know PRO profile. That will be only for running AD. And shall I do it for full import to start with? Full import, full sync, and there's no threshold, it's a test environment in your scenario. So for each activities you have to create different profile. For this one's full import, full sync, next, and ITLND, these are the sizes, I'm going to leave them as default, finish and apply. Okay, and okay, and then you can do again right click, you can go for configure profile, and this scenario new profile I will say AD underscore this time Delta, where the other one's full, here's only Delta import and Delta sync, next, and finish, apply. This is just you know, I take the what I've got Delta, I've got full, and one more time we call it AD underscore Delta staging only, stage, next, this is only staging only. Okay, doing only import. You can see logon options, you can see where you can create a logon if needed. Next here, and same, only importing, apply. So later on we will change these ones, you know, and you got new steps where you can change the configuration, but I'm just gonna leave it as it is. Okay, here, so just to show you, the first one is you can do right click and you can do run. Here when you do run, tell you what you want to do with this run. Would you like to import, sync? In this scenario, to be honest with you, I just want to do full import, so I have not created full import. I'm just gonna do create, and let's do just full import if needed. So AD underscore full import, if that makes sense, full import. Okay, next, where is the full import stage only, next, and finish it. Okay, so all, here we go, and we got four profiles. This is the best practice of creating different profiles. So I'll say run what you would like to run. Let's just do only full import, here we go, run it full import, and let's we have a look what it will import. So operation, you can go here, still running, you see success. So I've added for me 30 objects and see no issues, and you can see here we go, these are the objects it's imported for me. You can see most of them are user accounts, group, policy, domain, admins, enterprise, the object which I have selected. You can do properties, I can see exactly some account CNAME, and if you would like to do the preview you will see exactly what happened. So start, and you can see the objects, and you can see what happened to this object. So that's all what I had for us today, and we created the AD account. Hopefully we will go through different video to do different activity around the AD art later on. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.